Here's just one of the specialist tools you'll learn about in the Engine Building Fundamentals course.
When it comes to building engines, the micrometer is one of the most common pieces of precision measuring equipment that we're going to be using. Now, I know that a lot of novice engine builders and mechanics really struggle with how to correctly use and read a micrometer. So in this module, we're going to see exactly how to go about doing it. Now, while there are a few varieties of micrometer available, we're going to be focusing here on an imperial scaled vernier micrometer. Now, of course, if you're using a digital micrometer, using the micrometer is relatively straightforward because the reading will be displayed digitally right in front of you. However, as we've already found out, we are going to need a range of different micrometers in order to measure the different sizes we're likely to come across in the engine. And since the digital micrometer is more expensive than a conventional mic, this is going to add greatly to the cost of your toolset. Now, here in front of me, I have two micrometers, and these are a relatively cheap brand coming out of China, as we see with a lot of the common equipment we're going to be using these days in engine building. And in front of me here, I have a 0-1 inch mic, and then I have a 1-2 inch mic. This particular set goes all the way up to 6 inches, and we're simply going to select the micrometer that's suitable for whatever we're actually trying to measure. Now, with the micrometers, there are two different types. There is a vernier micrometer, which is what we're going to be looking at today. This is able to measure down to 4 decimal places, or 1/10,000th of an inch. Or we can use a conventional or standard micrometer. This eliminates the vernier scale and is able to measure down to 1/1,000th of an inch. For today's lesson, we will be looking at the vernier scale. However, what we're going to learn will be applicable to a standard micrometer as well. Before we get started using the micrometer, we're just going to have a look at the different components that make up the micrometer. This is our 1-2 inch micrometer, and first of all, we're going to have a look on the little plaque here. We can see that it's labeled 1-2 inch. We can also see that the precision of this micrometer is also listed. You can see it's listed at 0.0001 of an inch, or 1/10,000th of an inch. I'm just going to flip it around so we can actually see the scale, and we'll just talk about the different components of the micrometer. First of all, we have the frame, which actually holds both ends of the micrometer. The two measuring surfaces are between here and here. This particular component is known as the anvil, and this part which moves as we turn the screw thread is known as the spindle. Here we have our measuring scale, which we'll be looking at in more detail shortly. This particular component where our scale is written is known as the barrel or sleeve of the micrometer. Next we have the turning component, which is known as the thimble. And finally, at the end, we have our ratchet stop, which is what we're going to be using for actually tightening the micrometer down on the component we're measuring. We also have a positive stop, which we can use to lock the micrometer once we've measured the component of interest. Now that we've seen the different components of the micrometer, we're going to look at how we can actually use a micrometer to make a measurement. Before we make any measurements, it's important to make sure that the measurement faces of the anvil and the spindle are both clean and free of dirt and debris, as these can have a dramatic effect on the accuracy of our reading. Now, what we're going to do is close down the micrometer and just make sure that it is able to accurately read zero. So what we're looking at here is that this zero line here lines up correctly and accurately with the zero mark on the barrel of the micrometer. Now we're just going to talk about what each of these increments mean. Now the increments on the thimble of the micrometer represent 1/1,000th of an inch. So every time we move past one of these increments, we're increasing by 1/1,000th of an inch. So at this point, we're reading 5/1,000th of an inch. Now every time we go through one full revolution, we come back to zero. This means that the micrometer has incremented by 25/1,000th of an inch. And we can also see that as we do this, a new mark is now visible on the barrel of the micrometer. So I'll just open it up a little bit further so we can see these marks a little bit more clearly. So each of the marks along the barrel represents 25/1,000th of an inch. And we can see that when we get out to four of these marks, we have a value of 1, and this represents a tenth of an inch, or 0.1 of an inch. Now, on the top of the scale here, we have our vernier marks, and these are going to be used to define our fourth decimal point, or our 10,000th of an inch precision, and we'll see how that works shortly. Now that we know a little bit more about what these numbers mean, let's actually measure a component and see how this all works. Okay, so now we're going to actually measure the width of this piece of aluminium. And you can see how I'm holding the micrometer. They're made to be used in your right hand. And while this is a little bit tricky because it is a small micrometer, you can see I've got my little finger just looped through the frame, and I'm using my thumb and forefinger on the spindle. We can make coarse adjustments by using the thimble, but when we get to a point where we're actually ready to make a measurement, it's important to use the ratchet stop. And this prevents us over tightening the micrometer. So once we've got the micrometer tightened and it's stopped moving, we can then lock it. We can remove the component that we're measuring. Let's now have a look at how we can calculate or measure the component that we've just put in our micrometer. When you're learning to read a micrometer, it's valuable to write down each of the measurements as you read them and then add them together. This makes it very clear exactly what the measurements are, and we're going to do that. But let's have a look at what the numbers mean. The first thing we want to look at is how many numbers are visible on the barrel or sleeve of our micrometer. Here you can see that we have the number 3 being exposed, and what this means is that we have a measurement of 0.3 inches. Beyond that, though, we can also see we have 3 more increments exposed. Remember, each of those increments represents 25 thousandths of an inch, so 3 of those represents 0.075 inches. So we know that at this point we have 0.375 inches. We can also see, though, that we've come up just beyond the number 5. Remember, the thimble here represents thousandths of an inch, and we can see that we've gone a little bit past the 5. So we're somewhere beyond 5 thousandths of an inch, and this is where the vernier scale comes in. What we want to do is have a look at our vernier scale and see which line comes closest to lining up. We can see in this point the 6 lines up correctly with our vernier scale, which is our fourth decimal point, or 0.0006 of an inch. Let's write all those down and add them up so we can see what our final value is. When it comes to writing down the measurements from our micrometer, it's always best to look at them each individually and then add them up. We're going to start with our tenth of an inch measurement, which we can see here. Remember, we had our value of 3, our measurement of 3 visible, and that represents 0.3 of an inch. I'm just going to add out to our 4 decimal places just so everything lines up when I've got the rest of our measurements listed. Next, we have our little increments, and you'll remember each of those smaller increments represents 25 thousandths of an inch. We can see that 3 of these are visible, and that represents 0.075 of an inch. So let's write that down. Now we can see that we've also gone past on our thimble here, we've gone past our 5 thou mark, so we're going to also write that down. And you'll remember that when we were looking at our vernier scale on the top of the mic, we had 6 ten thousandths of an inch. So we'll write down our last value there as well. Okay, so this represents the measurement from our micrometer, and all we need to do now is add up the different values. So we have 6 ten thousandths of an inch. We have 2 fives here, which add up to equal 10. So we're just going to carry the 1. We have an 8 and a 3, so our final measurement is 0.3806 of an inch. Like any piece of equipment, using a micrometer does take some practice to become competent with, but now you should understand the process to go through and how to correctly read the numbers on the micrometer.
That was just one of the modules from the Engine Building Fundamentals course, which is the perfect starting place if you want to learn how to assemble high-performance engines. This course will teach you about engine anatomy, essential engine machining processes, how to select and measure critical clearances in your engine, how to assemble the engine long block, and how to break in your fresh engine. For more information and to purchase the course, click the link now.